Wilson, how do you feel like the situation in Palestine was different this year, distinctly different than the years before?
The situation in Palestine has always been heated. Clashes between Israeli occupation forces and Palestinian protesters are actually the norm in Palestine. But 2018 was, to some extent, exceptional in the way that Palestinians exhibited their will to seek their national rights. By the month of March, almost, I would say, hundreds of thousands of Palestinians started staging one of the largest unarmed civil protests in their national history. It started in Gaza. It still continues up till today. We are talking about 40 weeks of protests that involve people of all sorts of backgrounds. They all demand return to their homelands and end of the illegal Israeli siege on the Gaza Strip. The Palestinian protests continued also in the West Bank and in Jerusalem in particular due to ongoing Israeli Judaization policies in the city of Jerusalem. The number of casualties, as you have mentioned earlier, is beyond 290, but 241 of these were unarmed civilians who were protesting near the fence between Gaza and the Israeli occupation. And these people were targeted by Israeli snipers, well-trained Israeli snipers using state-of-the-art sophisticated weaponry. They were targeting these unarmed protesters in order to kill. And the large number of casualties and the large number of paramedics and journalists targeted proves that Israeli snipers were actually ordered to shoot to kill these protesters. As long as there is an Israeli occupation, Palestinians will certainly protest and exhibit their hopes for self-determination and freedom. But the Palestinians cannot continue to do this all on their own. International intervention has to come. And I think one of the messages that the Great Return March demonstrations in Gaza is sending to the world is that the international community has to come and intervene. Israel is bluntly violating international laws, international resolutions on a daily basis, and this has to come to an end. It is very unfortunate that the current American administration is giving the cover to the Israeli government, Israeli right-wing government led by Netanyahu. But I would say that international anger over this American endorsement of Israeli occupation policies is also on the rise. We've seen that in the United Nations General Assembly votes on different occasions. The world is upset at what the Israeli governments are doing against the Palestinian civilians. And the trend is still continuing. More and more are joining and backing the Palestinian struggle for freedom. It's a matter of time to see the Israeli occupation come to an end. But I would say if concrete measures were not taken by the international community, more